Hello, it's me, Moses Ender. I'm sure you've heard news about battery fires, and while they are rare on a relative scale, the sheer amount of batteries present around us make them appear relevant on an absolute scale. So in this video, I decided to cover one of the safety features of cylindrical cells called the current interrupt device, or short, CID. This little thing keeps the battery safe even in abnormal conditions, for example, an external short circuit or an overcharging of a cell. And since the same device has a second safety feature included, you will also learn something about the safety vent. The purpose of the current interrupt device is to keep cylindrical lithium ion cells safe, even in case of abuse conditions. As the name suggests, it interrupts the main current path of the cell. That means it cuts the connection between the electrodes inside the cell and the positive terminal. So it is basically nothing more but a switch that is opened. The switch is pressure activated, so it is triggered if the pressure inside the cell housing increases beyond a critical level. That pressure increase is caused by additional gas that is generated inside the cell. The reasons for this gas generation can be side reactions, such as a decomposition of the electrolyte. This gas pressure is further amplified by increased temperatures that typically occur in abuse conditions. To understand better how the CID works, we have to take a closer look at the internal construction of a cylindrical lithium ion cell. The CID is located in the top cap of the cell. The electrodes that are wound to a cylindrical shape are connected to the cell can and to the positive terminal through one or more taps. The CID is located between the electrodes and the positive terminal and can therefore cut this connection. If we take now a closer look at the structure of the top cap, several components can be identified. The positive terminal, a burst disc, an insulator ring, and a current collector disc. The whole assembly is kept together by a sealing ring that seals and insulates the whole assembly against the cell can. The electrodes are connected to the current collector disc, so the pressure has to disable the connection between the current collector disc and the positive terminal. To achieve this, the burst disc and the current collector disc are separated from each other by an insulator ring, except a small contact point at the center. To guarantee a reliable, low resistance contact between those discs, they are typically spot welded together at the contact point. To allow the pressure inside the cell to act on the burst disc only, the current collector disc requires some openings. A pressure increase leads therefore only to a force on the burst disc. Once the pressure increases beyond a critical level, the burst disc vents outwards and the contact is opened. During this, the welding point is either ripped off or a defined weak point at the current collector disc breaks open to interrupt the current path. From that time on, no current can be drawn anymore from the cell. That means the cause of the pressure increase, for example, an overcharging of the cell, is stopped. If the pressure in the cell should anyway increase further, the risk increases that the cell explodes. This can happen through continued side reactions or continued heating of the cell. To avoid such an uncontrolled explosion, there are grooves in the burst disc. These grooves define the weakest point of the cell housing and rupture first, leading to a controlled venting of the pressure in the cell. How the mechanical details of the top cap assembly exactly look like is different from cell manufacturer to cell manufacturer, but the principle is always the same. Some examples of how such a cap structure looks like can be found in this paper authored by Jason Ostenek and his co-authors. In their study, they also included some X-ray tomography scans that show how these structures look like once the CID has been activated or the emergency vent has been triggered. In case of an abnormal condition, the cell has to be deactivated before a more catastrophic battery failure can occur. That leads in the worst case to a fire or explosion. Therefore, the whole system has to be properly designed. That means the mechanical properties of the CID and the vent, which are defining the triggering pressures, have to be properly matched with the cell chemistry that defines the gas generation. In the paper I mentioned before, the authors have also measured these activation pressures. They are around 1 megapascal, or 10 atmospheres if you are more familiar with that, for the CID activation, and around 2 megapascal for the venting, corresponding to around 20 atmospheres. I can highly recommend to take a closer look at this paper if you are interested in this topic. You can find the link in the description below. To summarize, the CID is responsible to stop the current flow through a cylindrical cell in case it would otherwise lead to a potentially dangerous state. It does that by using the pressure increase inside the cell to mechanically break a connection. With this understanding, I want to underline a warning that apparently has not yet reached enough people. On YouTube, there are numerous videos showing how to reactivate dead lithium-ion cells. These cells show 0 volt because the CID has triggered. The so-called reactivation happens by mechanically manipulating the triggered CID to re-establish the contact between the two discs. Well, there's always a reason why the CID has triggered. Bypassing this important safety mechanism to continue operation of the cell can lead to a catastrophic battery failure, resulting in a fire or explosion. Also, you have seen that these discs that you are trying to push back also includes the vent structure. This disc is mechanically the weakest point of the cell. If you break it open while trying to push it back, it can be exposed to the fumes of the electrolyte, which are toxic. So please, don't do that and share this video with your friends to keep everybody safe. That's it for today. I hope you found this video interesting and you learned something new. If you have further questions, let me know in the comments below. And in case you found that video useful, please leave a like and subscribe. Till next time, stay charged!